The Dow also taking a deep dive on the worst day yet for the TSX so far this year. Asian markets also not faring very well so far. So what's behind this downturn? Well, Tyler Orton with Business in Vancouver is joining us now for more. So Tyler, what is contributing to these major losses?
You know, if you want to look at where investor confidence is, that's what it really comes down to in layman's terms here right now. The bond markets don't look great, as well as the fact that trade tensions between the United States and China continue to simmer. And that's giving a lot of signals that the health of the global economy might not be doing so well further on. I'm a little surprised. I was looking at where markets are standing right now. They just opened up a few minutes ago. I was expecting that the Dow, as well as the TSX S&P Composite Index, would be rising a little bit higher after plummeting quite a bit yesterday. Worst performances for each of them. We saw that throughout North American markets. The other thing keeping our eyes on right now is how European markets were faring not so well, and Asian markets, it was a little bit more mixed, because we actually saw China putting out different statements yesterday leading into today. And the last statement, though, is a little bit more conciliatory towards the United States and making sure that trade tensions simmer down just a little bit. So we do see Asian markets picking up just a little bit from where they were as of last night.
Yeah, a lot of factors at play there. All right, let's shift over to a product call to pot producers. BC's liquor distribution branch wants to hear from cannabis suppliers as edibles are soon to be legalized. So what can we expect from this call for new products?
Well, timing is very important here because, as you say, edibles will be legalized soon by Ottawa. And so the liquor distribution branch is calling for licensed producers to identify their interests and their ability to supply as well as edibles, beverages, topicals, and extracts. This begins this month and it goes into mid-September as well for about 30 licensed producers that the liquor distribution branch is working with right now. The products would be available in both the private stores here in British Columbia as well as the government-run BC cannabis stores. Now, I want to say this, though. This is supposed to be a very gradual rollout moving forward, and I would not expect any of these products to be available until about mid-December. So I don't know if you can find a couple stocking stuffers for people later on. I just don't think that they're going to be in much quantity until probably 2020, maybe closer to like February at this point.
All right. Important disclaimer there. Tyler Orton with Business in Vancouver. Thanks very much.
Thank you.